something, trying to talk them into the closet of prayer. I'm going to tell you one more time, if the women of God will dedicate themselves to the closet of prayer, we can change the course of history in America, because 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people who are called by my name. Now, I'm going to tell you something about a bunch of women getting dedicated to the closet of prayer, getting in there every day, that'll stir up heaven. It'll stir up heaven. It'll stir up your family. It'll stir up your church. Now, I'm going to tell you something. I tell this everywhere I go. This right here is the most important place on the face of the earth. Right here. God said it. It's a hard sale. I don't know why it is, but it's a hard sale. But my mother spent her lifetime praying for this pulpit and the man that would stand behind this sacred desk. How can they hear without a preacher? They can't do it. And so if you build a wall around this pulpit and keep that wall prayed up, it'll be amazing. You think he preaches good now? You ain't heard nothing yet. Only get a bunch of Holy Ghost filled women praying for you, and they'll preach you to death. We need to pray for the shepherds. We need to constantly be building walls around them. I found that when I was a little girl, 9 years old, that all I had to do was bow. Just bow my old heart to Jesus. Give him my will and save my soul. When my son left home, I found out all I had to do was bow. That's all we have to do, ladies, is bow.